Hello everyone. I hope you're having a blessed and beautiful day today. Took the kids to VBS this morning actually, and so I have quite a lot of time to be alone and just be quiet, and I can come on here and read an article for you. I have another one that I wanted to read to you, but it is really, really long, so I'm just gonna kind of skim through it, and then I'll link it in the description box so you guys can kind of go through it yourself, because it is really, really, really long. This one I got off of Fox News, and it is based out of CNN, but I don't normally trust CNN, but I just happened to see the article, or not the article, the interview that the virologist was giving, and she said it with her mouth, so that is why I am going to go ahead and read it now, because I heard her say it. It wasn't just like a news story that CNN is trying to share or whatever. It says, CNN medical analyst suggests life needs to be hard for the unjabbed Americans. CNN medical contributor Dr. Nguyen suggested Saturday that life needs to be hard for Americans who have not received the jab, and individuals who refuse to get the jab should perhaps face weekly testings. It needs to be hard for people to remain unjabbed, when the former Planned Parenthood president said. Right now, it's kind of the opposite. Unjabbed people, she fretted, can at the moment go about their lives as normal without any consequences. But at some point, these mandates by workplaces, by schools, I think it will be important to say, hey, you can opt out if you want to opt out. You have to sign these forms. You have to get twice weekly testings. Nguyen said, basically, we need to make getting jabbed an easy choice. Okay, so there's that one. See, there was another one here. Excuse me for a minute while I get over there. Okay, this is off of InfoWars. I don't know exactly really a lot about this website, but I saw the article, and that this is the one I wanted to share with you. And you can kind of go and read it on your own, because it is very, very long. This says, government document instructs jab strike force teams how to clear buildings, violate trespass laws, and flag anti-jabbers for forced quarantine. What do you want? Come on. Let me get over here. Come. Oh, sorry, guys. let's see here. A government document that has recently surfaced offers horrifying details on how door-to-door strike force jab enforcement teams plan to operate. Labeled Community Health Ambassador Outreach Door Knocking Project, a now public document published by the government of Lake County, Illinois, instructs ambassadors to violate no soliciting restrictions and illegally trespass onto private property, impersonate health department officials and attempt to intimidate building managers into consenting to allow entry for the strike force teams, lie to the public and falsely claim jabs are safe by withholding information about serious side effects, clear buildings in military fashion, going floor by floor, wing by wing, knocking on doors and intimidating residents of residential units and apartment buildings, recording the location, addresses, room numbers of anti-jabbers in order to feed this information into a government database for further action, most likely forced quarantine, removal, or medical kidnapping. White House spokesperson Jen Psaki, I can't remember how she said her name, announced last week that the Biden regime would activate door-to-door strike forces to coerce more people into getting jabbed. Let's see here. These teams are instructed to lie to the public and imply that these are approved jabs, which are completely safe. In truth, none of the jabs are FDA approved, and all of them have been linked to hospitalization, deaths, and long list of side effects, including heart inflammation, heart attacks, strokes, blood clots, muscle tremors, neurological problems, and more. The document instructs strike force team members to illegally trespass onto private property, instructing them to ignore no soliciting signs Once they illegally obtain access to a building by violating no soliciting signs, they are instructed to impersonate health department officials, which is also illegal under the Illinois law. Here is an explanation given in the document. Ignore all soliciting signs. You are not soliciting. You are offering critical information and resources. What you are doing is not illegal. Let's see here. Sorry guys, I'm going through here. Make sure I give everything. It's okay. Okay, gives instructions for clearing residential buildings floor by floor while meticulously recording the location of those who refuse the job. From the document, after you enter the building, orient yourself so you systematically proceed from floor to floor, covering each wing. Utilize the tally sheet to keep count of those interested in getting the job and those who refuse and those with further questions. This instruction smacks of military or law enforcement building clearing activities, and its purpose seems clear: to canvass the entire building and record the locations of people who refuse the job. The obvious question becomes, why would the government need a database of the physical location of people who refuse the job? The obvious answer is because they plan to come back and they need to know where these people are located. There are really only two logical reasons why the government would come back. One, to force the jab onto these people, or two, medically kidnap them and take them away to a quarantine center, almost certainly run by FEMA. Okay, I'll leave that there. All right. So there's that one, and then there's this one here. Just the other day, the government, I don't remember what his name was, but he was saying how it's the government's business to know who isn't jabbed and who is jabbed. And so they're starting to get into people's business, like personal business. It's getting to the point where people are losing their freedoms. They're losing their rights. And it's not just here in America, okay? It's happening everywhere. England is one of the biggest. I just saw a video yesterday in Australia where they pepper sprayed and arrested children because the parents, they didn't have masks on, the children. And so they were arresting these little kids and pepper spraying them because they didn't have one on. And so, you know, the tyranny is getting worse and worse by the day. This one says DHS training program prepares for rural lockdowns, mass public quarantines against the unjabbed. A Department of Homeland Security training program has provided a model for the federal government to normalize mass public quarantine measures despite the fact infections and deaths are dropping in the United States. The website by the Rural Domestic Preparedness Consortium, RDPC, a training provider for the Department of Homeland Security, outlines in a program called MGT-433 Isolation and Quarantine for Rural Communities, has to begin rounding up unjabbed American citizens for mass quarantine centers. This 8-hour instructor-led course is designed to provide the knowledge necessary to begin planning for situations requiring the isolation and quarantine of a large portion of a local rural population, the RDPC website states. This training will provide public and private sector emergency managers, community policy makers, public health, and public safety personnel with the general knowledge necessary to begin planning for situations requiring isolation quarantine of a large population. Okay, and this came after the Biden administration prepares to deploy door-to-door vaccine strike forces nationwide. And okay, that's it for that. We also have that they are preparing to make the jab mandatory for all military personnel starting in September. So, you know, my husband hasn't gotten it yet. He's been able to kind of, sway out of that and not have to receive it. I don't know what's going to happen if we're still here in September. I don't know what's going to happen and if he's going to take it or, you know, it's going to become mandatory where he has to take it. I don't know because he's in the service and, you know, so I don't know. Right. All right. That's about it for that. Okay. Anyways, guys, I wanted to share these updates with you guys. There's so much going on so fast that it's hard to keep up sometimes. And there's so many different things that it's hard to decide what I want to share and what I want to read because there's just so much going on. You know, the one thing that bothers me is when I see people getting angry that you're trying to scare people into heaven. And really, ultimately, you know, we need to share the truth with people. We need to say, hey, you know what? These things that are going on for a reason. And the Bible tells us that this is the Jesus is coming back. And if you don't have him, if you don't accept him, then you will be entering into the tribulation if you make it into the tribulation. Because we have to remember that when the rapture happens, that so much chaos is going to happen globally that, you know, planes are going to fall out of the sky, trains are going to derail, cars are going to be off the road. You know, everything that you could think of, you know, is going to go wrong. People are going to be in surgery with a doctor that goes missing. You know, they're going to be strapped to a table. You know, there's going to be death worldwide. And who's to say that you're not one of them? So if you even make it into the tribulation, and unfortunately, we have people that are saying, well, we shouldn't be talking to them about the tribulation. We shouldn't be scaring them into heaven. And ultimately, we need to actually scare them into heaven because we need to really, you know, tell them the truth. And like I posted on my community tab yesterday, that, you know, not telling somebody about the tribulation and how to get out of it is like giving people a mound of candy and not warning them about the decay that's going to come after. And we need to stop giving people sugar and we need to start giving them the truth, regardless if it's hurtful, regardless if it's harsh, regardless of, you know, if you don't like it. You know, people need to stop being a cotton candy Christian and going to these cotton candy churches where everything is sweet and sugary. And we need to start becoming these bold lioness and lions that God has called us to be and share the gospel with people and the true gospel with people and sharing how to get out of the tribulation. And what you are seeing now is the end of the end. This is it, guys. We are at the end, okay? If we do not share the truth with people, and that includes the tribulation, and that includes if you die and you die without Jesus, that you're going to hell. You know, we need to share all of these things with people and not be ashamed to share the tribulation with people, or, you know, share how to get saved. And this is how you can get out of the tribulation. This is how you can get out of hell. This is what you do. You know, stop giving people, you know, this soft gospel and not giving them the true gospel where Jesus has said, you know, I am the way, you know. If you don't want to share the gospel with people, if you don't want to share what's going to happen to people when they die, if you don't want to share what's going to happen to people when Jesus comes back, then are you ashamed to share it? Are you ashamed of Jesus? Because I think a lot of people need to be more like John the Baptist, where he didn't really care what people said. He was going to share the gospel with people regardless of what they said. And instead, we've got a lot of people that don't want to be the John the Baptist anymore. They want to stay quiet. They don't want to share the truth. They don't want to share this gift that they have. They don't want to share this, you know, vaccine. You don't want to share it with people because if you have the cure for their death sentence, and if you don't want to share it, then you're ashamed of it. And it's really sad that you have a lot of people that you know, are saying, well, you know, don't tell people about the tribulation. You know, don't tell people that they're going to go to hell, because it scares them. And it scares them, you know, to the point where you're scaring them into a false belief. Baloney. Okay? That's not up to you. You're not the one that's saving them in the first place. Okay? We need to share the truth with people. And if it scares them, then God is the one that's going to do the work. God is the one that's going to work on their heart. God is the one that's going to save them. Not you, not me, not anybody. And so if you feel that urgency that Jesus is coming, by all means, share it with people. Be that John the Baptist of today. Share the gospel with people. Share with them how to get out of the tribulation, how to get out of hell, and what will happen if they choose to reject Christ. Plain and simple. Don't be a cotton candy Christian. Don't go to a cotton candy church. Plain and simple. So, that is what I have to say today. Anyways, guys, I wanted to share those articles with you. I will post a link to the article that I read in the description box. And yeah, so if you want to read it, you can. I will hopefully be back tomorrow with some more news or whatever I wanted to talk about. Like I said, the kids are in VBS this week, so I have 4 hours to myself. So I'm able to do stuff like this. So anyways, guys, I love you. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, and may you be richly blessed.